June 26th, a day in which Eddie Rosario's 2019 season was derailed. There he is coming up limping. He suffers a left ankle sprain on this play and really was never the same after this point. He was headed to a likely all-star appearance, may have even participated in the home run derby. He ranked 6th in the American League in home runs at the time of this injury and was really lighting it up. But after suffering that left ankle sprain, take a look at the numbers before he went to the injured list and after he went to the injured list. The OPS is nearly 100 points lower. He went from being 15% above average in terms of WRC plus to 11% below average. Even the ex-WOBA rating the contact, quality of contact, is way lower after that point. As you can see, F-WAR, Fangraphs WAR, 1.1 before, 0 after. Let's take a look at some highlights. On the left, you're going to see healthy Eddie. On the right, you're going to see post-injury Eddie. And these aren't the exact plays, but I want you to take note of the aggressiveness in which Eddie's playing before he suffers that injury versus how hesitant he is. Look at where, again, this is just the injured part. That is not regular Eddie Rosario. It's very similar plays here. Again, you can see how much more aggressively he's attacking the ball on the left compared to the right. And in particular on this play, I noticed that he comes up. It's apparent that stopping in particular seems uncomfortable for him at that point. Again, left is healthy Eddie, right is injured Eddie, and just the same consistency, so much more aggressive at attacking the ball and cutting it off. A lot more effort put in, and again, here's just the injured Eddie. Look at how he's just, there's not enough there. He's trying to not stretch himself, and you can see this had a great impact on his defensive metrics. I'll point out, this is from Baseball Savant. On the left here, you see his OAA, outs above average. The previous 3 years combined, he was a positive 1 outs above average. That dropped all the way to minus 13. Where it really hurt him was the jump. Those are color-coded, so the darker red is good, the darker blue is poor. So he went from being above average to being far below average from 1 year to the next. That doesn't seem to add up to me. Let's take a look at him running. Now, these are two very different plays. I'll admit, on the left, he's healthy and trying to leg out a double. On the right, he's not healthy, but he's also not as competitive of a play. But we'll take a look again. He doesn't look right. That doesn't seem like a guy who's comfortable with me. Now let's watch him beat out a single to the pitcher. Again, left healthy Eddie, right injured Eddie. He is a step slower. And both these plays, he's trying to beat out that single. He is a full step slower post-injury than he was pre-injury. And we'll take a look at Baseball Savant again. You can see his sprint speed in terms of feet per second dropped from 28 to 27.1 last season. That impacted his home plate to first times. But then if you look at the very far right, percentage rank in terms of the entire league, he was in the top 75.9% the year before and only in the top 55.3%. He was barely above average in terms of sprint speed last year. I think that greatly had to do with that injury. And that explains those dips in the defense and the dips in the base running metrics. But what about the plate discipline? Well, you can't really blame an injury on that. But luckily, Eddie has come into spring training and is saying that he wants to draw more walks, swing at better pitches. And, you know, if you're looking for another glimmer of positivity, of hope for Eddie Rosario, take a look at this graph from Fangraphs. This doesn't make any sense, okay? The red line is Eddie Rosario's batting average on balls in play from year to year. The blue line is his hard hit percentage. So as his hard hit percentage has gone up, his batting average on balls in play has gone down. That doesn't make any sense, right? Now, even though I'm very optimistic about Eddie Rosario, anybody who has an issue with him batting cleanup, I understand that. This is a very impressive lineup that the Twins are going to have in 2020. There are probably better options to hit that high in the order in that key of a spot. Anybody who kind of was rooting for the Twins to dangle him out in a potential trade for pitching, I get that too. If you kind of look across the board, the Twins can afford to give up some offense in return for some pitching, and Eddie Rosario is probably the most replaceable guy in the starting lineup. There's lots of corner outfield depth in this organization. So I don't want to make it sound like I'm completely discrediting any of those conversations. I'm just trying to say, when you're trying to look at a big picture and judge a guy based on, you know, his WAR, try to make really concrete reflections on his defense and his base running, Well, this is a thing you have to keep in mind. He was injured. I don't think he ever was 100% after that, to be honest. Now, I don't know if I can prove that or not. I think this video certainly gives some evidence to support that. And if you like this video, please consider giving me a thumbs up. If you want to see more Twins content on YouTube, please subscribe. Thank you so much for checking out this video. We'll talk again soon.